Hello and welcome to DTLT today. On my right, your left, we have this guy, who you already know. His name is Jim Groom. But on my other side, someone you may or may not know. We think he's famous, but to you, he may be infamous.
I'm Carl Rove.
We have Carl Rove joining us. Before he goes to tonight's Fredericksburg Forum, he's going to speak to us.
I want to speak to the people.
I've never seen you wear sunglasses before. And the ponytail, I always thought you were against hippies.
Yeah, but. Well, I've come around like many people on this couch.
Actually, no. It's not Carl Rove. It's Alan Levine from who knows where these days.
Fredericksburg right now.
Exactly.
I'm on the couch, baby.
You could say from Arizona, but you've been from Canada and all points in between here and Vancouver. So
Moose Jaw, baby.
Moose Jaw.
Moose Jaw is where it's happening.
Regina.
Regina. Victoria.
Calgary.
Calgary. New Jersey, even.
State College, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, I was there, yeah.
All kinds of places. So, and you're originally from?
Strawberry, Arizona.
Oh, you are? Okay. Your Baltimore connection.
Baltimore, yeah, that's where I grew up.
Okay. All right, so.
Baltimore.
You are a well-traveled man.
Yeah. I'm here for Bavistock, baby.
Bavistock 11.
Yeah, Bavistock 11.
It's the sunshine.
Oh, that's right.
The sunshine ready. People are out.
The hippies will reign again. The sunshine's out.
The hippies are right.
The dog is here.
The hippies are right, baby.
We're going to see if we survive until
it's gonna be
Monday.
It's going to be sick.
Yeah, we're not playing around here. If you're in Fredericksburg and you're not at my house on Saturday, well then.
And if you read Jim's blog, he invited the entire internet to his house.
I did invite the internet. Just let me know when you want to come.
Yep.
That's all. Just give me a heads up.
That's right. You can stay in Jim's room.
You can stay with me.
All 3 billion of you on the internet.
Exactly. Come on over.
So, Alan, we have you here today to talk about this thing called a story box, I think.
Yeah.
Here it is. What can you.
Here it is.
Look how small it is.
That's everybody's house of story boxes.
It's much smaller than you think. It really is. It couldn't even. It's almost like a hipster lunchbox.
It is
because it can only hold like sushi. Like, it can hold like anything other than sushi.
Or maybe some like makeup or things like that.
Makeup that could be a good thing for it.
Yeah, small water bottle.
Right.
Or maybe
little
some
slice
stories.
Of lemon.
Maybe some story. So I mean, Jim, you have a lot to do with this becoming the story box, but. This thing is called, actually it's called a pirate box, and it's a little bit of technology that Grant Potter and Zach Dowell got us tuned into through DS-106.
So it doesn't glow when you open it like that.
No, it doesn't glow when you open it.
Like the repo man
box. I can't see on the camera if I'm getting too close with the thing.
Be closer.
Yeah,
there we go.
Oh, wow, there it is.
That's awesome.
Right. So here's the story box. So it's all kind of technology you can buy. It's about $100 worth of stuff. So this is a thing called a DockStar router, and it's connected to this little wireless transmitter, and on that thumb drive is running a Python web server, and the whole idea is it created a local network wherever it goes called StoryBox Share Yours, and if you connect
can
to
you
it
hear him okay? 'Cause
and you try to go to the internet, instead of going to the internet, you go to the web server that's on the box. So it's like the internet, except that you're not really on the internet. And the whole interface is built around this idea of open content and sharing. And the guy who invented it, David Darts, is an NYU art professor. And he was looking for a way for students in class to be able to anonymously share files without dealing with file servers and logins. So he came up with this technology and kind of he put the whole recipe on his wiki. I think it's wiki.daviddarts.com or org or something like that. Do a search for Pirate Box.
And we'll try to put this in the show notes.
We will put this in the show notes.
Exactly. Because that's what guys who host these web shows
this guy
say.
David Darts, how long ago did he come up with this?
I think it was maybe a year or two ago.
Wow.
And it got picked up by a couple like Ars Virtua, and it's referred to as an artistic provocation. Because the whole idea is that you put this thing in a public place, and theoretically, people would look at this network out of curiosity. Now, my question is, if you were in a public coffee shop and saw a network called Pirate Box share freely, would you join it?
Right.
Jim might, yeah.
I might, yeah.
Some might.
Probably not, though.
But I've been thinking, since most places you go, you don't see that many open wireless networks anymore, so people might connect to it.
Yeah.
But the idea is that they could go on it, and we'll show you in a second what you see,
You can upload content to it, and you can download content from it. So it's all about sharing content.
That's cool.
But the gist is that the only place where it exists right now is in my little lunchbox. So I've been traveling around the country with it. And it was really Noise Professor's idea when he came across this. He said he wanted to build one.
Yeah.
And he's that kind of guy who builds things. I don't.
He's like a soldering guy.
He's a maniac soldering guy, and he knows how to do it like so it solders like legibly. And he wrote me and said, if I build one, will you take it on your trip?
Yeah.
And I said, hell yeah. And it was when you visited Jim when we were talking about it before I even got it that, I mean, you're the one who called it a digital time capsule.
Yeah.
And that's what I've been keeping with.
Well, it was also based on, I loved story, I mean, Noise Professor's post about the story box that started a lot of this was interesting to me because he's like, it never lives outside of the box, right? For him, at least for the duration of the trip, it's this. And that's kind of like this other technology which has nothing to do with kind of like routers and stuff, this idea of letterboxing, where people drop these kind of like secret, like, notebooks around places that are cached and you can find them online. You can go there and sign them or do things with these letterboxes. And I love this idea of this being a drop space where people share stuff. And also that's stuff that I can't access until I'm seeing you face to face. There's something about that too that's intriguing right now.
And there's also, and maybe we'll switch to the interface so people can actually see what happens. Just let me know when it. So
there. Now they can hear you.
So all right.
Start.
We'll go back.
We'll go back. Welcome back. Welcome back. So here's the Pirate Box interface.
Yeah.
And the first two links are just informational. And then what I just did was I did an example of uploading a file. So I will pick another one from here. And I don't know what I'm sending. And basically on a laptop, you can send any file to the StoryBox.
Yeah.
And then when you go to the default view, which is a directory view, we can see now that that second one was called the Matrix. So that file has been uploaded and put on here. And I've been putting them into subdirectories. So I've got, these are all photos. And also as things have been coming in, I've been renaming them. How do you scroll on this thing? Because sometimes you get just photos like 1234.jpg.
Right. Yeah.
So I take a little bit of liberty with them. And when you look at this stuff, I know what a lot of this stuff is because I put a lot of content on here.
Yeah.
But it's really interesting when I sit with people to start, as they start looking through this stuff because they're asking questions about it. There's no context. You don't know where it is or what it is.
Totally.
And some of the stuff, awesome. I really don't know what it is because of the randomness. So I'm just trying to think of... these were some drunks that Alec Kurse and I met at Regina. These guys were smashed. This guy was slurring, and he was telling us some story. I have an audio recording of this guy telling us about the time his wife threw his shorts out. Now, I don't know what that means, but the whole part where, you know, Jim, you said it about being kind of a snapshot in time.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what all this
amazing
stuff is. And also, people have been sending me stuff, too, through my Dropbox, and I've been adding that as well. So I got... quite a bit of music And maybe
they've been sharing it with you.
They've been sharing it with
now,
me.
How many random people have just shared stuff with you that you were like, who actually went in and used the story box?
Like in a public place?
Yeah.
I have one photo that I think happened when I was at University of Delaware because I can't identify where it came from.
Really?
But I haven't been parked long enough in a public place, and I'm hoping maybe next week, maybe one day here, that we can just set up someplace on campus. And see what happens. The thing is, I think people need an invitation to join.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing I haven't really done a whole lot with is there's this anonymous chat area. So I'm thinking in a group setting, you could possibly have some group storytelling exercises where we pick a starting piece of media to look at. People kind of riff off of it, and then someone picks another piece of media. I'm thinking about seeing if I can write a script that would just pull up a picture at random. And say, okay, someone make a story about this, or do a Petya Flickr type thing with it. That's possible.
See, that's awesome.
The other thing that's been fun is that I'm interested in the idea of people doing remixes. So
Julie actually just sent a fork icon story of my story box.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So when I visited Julia, actually, since I was at her place, I gave her, and she was interested in this. I gave her a lot of the media that I had, and she did a remix of it. And I've been really interested to sort of do a workshop maybe where we put people in the room and say, look, you have to create something just out of the content that's on the story box, you know, and do a 5-picture story or take some images and put them with some of the audio that you find on there.
So that might be a good project for us Friday.
Yeah.
Is to actually do that.
Yeah, we could do this. So, you know, Julia took some music that the noise professor did, and I don't think you'll get the audio because we don't have the audio hooked up, but... she has a noise professor doing his banjo practice, and she had asked him on the radio to play some banjo music. So she did this video that's made just out of content that's on the story box.
That is awesome.
So all that stuff is from the story box. I did one simple one. And one thing I've also been fooling around with is trying to create some prettier ways to browse this content. So for the photos, I have a little thing that does thumbnail previews.
Oh, wow.
So you can...
So you've been working on an interface for the story box.
Yeah, because looking at the directory views is not very pleasant. Mm-hmm. So I have a little kind of hodgepodge screen system to...
What are you doing that with?
I have a copy of all the content on my laptop.
Yeah.
And I run it as a web server, and then I run PHP scripts that generate the thumbnails, and then generate these every night, or every time I update it. And then for, like, the audio... I'm not used to the scrolling here, so I must be lying. For like the music, let's say.
That is cool.
I convert all the audio I get to MP3s. So I make a little MP3 player off of a playlist. So there's about, there's probably about 15 songs. I just got one from Dr. Garcia did she did some singing, and Jabiz put some music on it, and Brian Jackson
right.
put some lead guitar, so they did kind of this group collaboration progress. And I can't wait to play for you guys the Pirate Box song that 1% Yellow did.
Oh, yeah.
It's really beautiful. Yeah, so
yeah,
folks at Bavistock will be able to tune in to the music. And then one last thing I've been trying to do is, let's see, on my Explore page, Explore. I've been fooling around with this. Come on, scroll, baby. Come on. Yeah, I know. Oh, it goes the wrong way. I'm deformed. I don't have line. Scott Leslie came up with this idea, like, since you have all this audio content, if you could have a playlist file generated. So it basically becomes its own radio station for the content that's on there. So
people can hear it.
I've been experimenting with that. It doesn't work exactly.
Do you have a lot of audio people put up?
Yeah, there's... The audio recordings, let's see. Well, you can see how much you're in here.
That's insane.
There's about 100 things. Wow. Some of them are interviews, like places I went. Sure. Like I interviewed the lady at the Gopher Hole Museum. And
that's awesome.
What's that?
How much?
Oh, it's got 16 gigs on the thumb drive, and I think I have about 3 gigs of content. So there's
really?
Room for more, okay? You can switch back to the...
Now, could you put just a small external hard drive in there?
Yeah, you could put anything. Okay. Well, the thing is, though...
Because that's what I thought that was when I first
that's,
saw it.
That's the battery
yeah,
supply
exactly.
for... Because it does have an AC adapter. The thing I don't know about is if you do a hard drive, if it will boot off of that. I assume it would. There's no reason why it couldn't boot plugged into this thing.
It's booting Linux, yes.
Yeah, it's booting Linux.
Yeah.
So I don't see why you couldn't do other storage.
What do I know about Linux?
But you could put a 32 or, you know, you could put a big ass, you know, thumb drive in there.
Well, sure. The other thing I was thinking about is how much range does that transmitter have? Like, could it get this whole room?
Yeah. Yeah, you could go down the hallway.
Really?
Yeah.
So we can get in a kind of public space here at Mayor Washington.
Yeah.
We could see what people would do.
Yeah. Especially, you know, what I keep thinking, and it's been suggested, is to make up some little cards. Mm-hmm. I mean, all you need to do is invite people in. You say, look, this is a project. Join this network and go to piratebox.local. I mean, from there, mm-hmm. I want them to figure out what to do.
So in other words, you just put them out on tables or wherever.
Yeah.
And say, hey, join this in.
Yeah.
That would be fun.
And to me, that's going to be most interesting is when there's people I don't know. I mean, I'm hopefully going to get a lot from, you know, everybody this weekend.
Yeah.
And for the stuff, again, I've asked people when they send it on the internet, with the idea of being a time capsule, is I've asked them to be not stuff that they share elsewhere.
That's right.
Like online. So the whole idea of the time capsule is that the only place you can see it is when I'm here. That's or when right. the box is here.
I love that idea.
And then at the end of my trip, I'm hoping to put it together and to, you know, put it back online and make a site where maybe people can create content out of it. Or maybe do a video out of it.
Well, even online, it still remains somewhat of a time capsule.
Yeah.
If it's in that context.
Yeah.
So that still remains consistent.
And I really, you know, the whole organic part of this is like, I don't know what it's going to become. It's kind of forming as it's going. But it's been a ton of fun. There's about close to 600 things on there. There's about 400 photos. And again, I bet a good 80% of it's my stuff because I'm putting stuff on it every day.
Yeah.
But it's been picking up. I've been getting, you know, getting some videos from people. Again, photos. Again, if you go to cogdogblog.com/storybox, that's the place where you can find where to go to the Dropbox to get it.
Yeah. Drop it to me.
Drop it to me. And I also have an email thing that sends it to my Dropbox as well.
Yeah, well, I haven't put anything in it yet.
I know, man.
I know. That's going
to
change.
There's a lot of people, man, been letting me down. I want Zach to do some music, you know. And
yeah.
You know, and Brian Jackson's come through with some good music for me, and Julia's been just peppering me with stuff. I mean, she's my favorite contributor.
Yeah.
And Dr. Garcia has sent a lot of videos, really fun stuff from her out and abouts.
Oh, really?
Yeah. She sends these short little clips, like when she's in the clubs, and there's these ones of people's like feet dancing, and she does a lot of her stuff just around you know, where she's at.
Yeah, she does. I mean, she's always on the move in the local.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, as you've been doing this, have you been kind of coming up with different storylines that you want to put together and post, or are you kind of just letting?
That's interesting. There's themes. There's a lot of things with water in it, so I did a remix with water.
Okay.
Partly because when I was in New York, I did this. They have this urban trail that's on an elevated subway platform, the High Line, that Mikhail told me about. Hmm. And when I went to get a drink of water, this computer voice started talking, and it was like this person telling me all about the powers of water. So I recorded it, and it's like, cool. Did you know that your body is made of 80% water? It's important to hydrate. So I took that audio and mixed it up, because I have a lot of videos of waterfalls, and I've been on a lot of boats, so I've got a fair amount of water things. There's kind of a theme of transportation, you know, because not only me traveling, but I've taken... And I've got stuff of trains and cars and boats. There's a lot of themes of farm animals. I've been to a couple farms, so that's been through there. And then just honestly, there's enough in there that I'm starting to forget what's on there.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's I'm really looking forward to this weekend in Bavistock to people to be not like putting stuff in there, but like reacting.
Yeah. Also watching stuff on there.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what I'm looking.
I mean, there's 100 videos, you know. And there's, you know, I haven't tallied up the total of the audio because some of them, David Kernahan gave me a full hour of Followers of the Apocalypse music. It's really trippy.
He put full hour
He put a full hour on there for me, yeah.
Oh, now, David Kernahan.
D. Kernahan,
David
yeah.
David Kernahan's who now?
He's in the UK.
Okay.
Yeah, oh, he's great. Followers of the Apocalypse.
Yeah.
Okay. And he's a big DS106 radio. He's one of the shows. And he hasn't really done a full-blown show because he's summer and everything else.
He did that one when I was driving back from D.C., the Eels cast.
That's right.
He's got me real interested in the Eels. I'm reading Mark Elliott's book right now.
Oh, really?
That he turned me on to.
He turned me on to the Eels, too, a couple of them when he was doing his. But he hasn't done a full-blown mix of Followers of the Apocalypse.
Yeah, that's what he gave me.
Yeah, that's it. So this is the first time in a while.
Yeah. Great. Well, and he said at the end of that cast, I caught him, he says he was going to slide me a copy because I sent him some photos for his Western presentation. So, Kernahan, thanks.
Yeah, that's awesome. Well, the story box is amazing, and what's great is now we can populate it with Bava, Bava stock and show
Bava stock and the stickers. The stickers are important.
Yeah,
people really got in the stickers, and I have to thank when I was at Darcy Norman's, and Evan came out with piles of stickers, and they really got into it. So there's layers of stickers. So there's a whole stratigraphy here of the trip that gets buried.
Another story.
Yeah, the actual physical thing.
So and of course. I need to have my recorder out next time I show it to someone who's seen it, because that same reaction is like, oh, it's much smaller than I thought.
I love how small it is, though, in some ways. And I'm going to show you, I got, me and Miles got a mail lunchbox that we want to put a pirate box in and play with this thing. So this might be a good time to look at it as you're over here the next week.
I told the folks at, when I was at the Center for History and New Media, and I've been thinking about this. I don't know if there's a place for it, but imagine a class where it's like part CIS of hardware, but also of using the technology for the creative side. So the first project, students and groups build a pirate box. So they have to be responsible for getting it to work. And then they're charged with taking it out and collecting the media. And then they're charged with sort of creating a project out of that media.
Yeah.
So if they don't do a good job collecting the media, they don't have good stuff to do their project. But that would cover the whole end from sort of hardware and that side to software and creativity.
Now, have you thought about putting the audio recording stuff in this to kind of put it out on the table and say, all right, go.
Yeah.
And then grab it directly to it?
Yeah.
I don't know, I don't know what software.
Oh, you mean to record directly to the bot?
Sure. You know, have.
When we were at Northern Voice, Jason Toll Dragon had an Android tablet. And if I understand right, he was able to record video and directly save it to the Pirate Box.
Wow.
And that's been one limitation, is that from most mobiles, except for a couple Android phones I've seen, you can't upload to it. Because you never have access, of course, in the iOS to a file system. And some Android phones do and some don't. But three people at my last demo were able to upload content directly from mobiles.
Okay.
So without access to upload from a mobile, and I've thought of like all kinds of ways to try to make that work, and haven't really found a fix to that. Okay. Because you know, on the iPhone, you don't really see files.
Yeah.
There is some code that Scott Leslie pointed out that might allow me to create a web form where you can access your images. Which would be kind of a start.
Or there might be some jailbroken system that would work, but other than that.
But the whole thing is, when you're off the internet, you know, you can't email to it, you can't upload it to Dropbox.
Yeah.
I mean, you're stuck with being able just to communicate. You could probably do FTP, but getting someone to be able to FTP from a mobile is kind of an uphill battle.
Yeah. Well, that's cool. I always like these cool little gadgets. And
I want to make one.
Yeah, to use it cuddle, first. Cuddle with it, baby.
That little good dog.
Yeah, I mean, and it is, and it's a little bit heavier, but I like the idea of just this box, and I like the idea that an art professor did it.
Yeah,
yeah.
For their class to share stories, and anonymous kind of images that then becomes
kind of glows.
That
too.
Then becomes a kind of you know, a project that people take up for all sorts of, and sticking in the kind of like. The theme of that, you're doing storytelling.
Yeah.
So,
thank you, Timmy.
Yeah. Thanks, Timmy, for everything. But that's
awesome.
It's cool. It's cool as hell. So
it is, man. It's been, honestly, you know, I really have to thank Zach a lot for doing this, because I wanted to do something on this trip, and the idea I had before was kind of okay, but not nearly as cool as this. And really, that conversation we had when you were in Arizona really gelled it for me. And I owe a lot to... I mean, lots of people for everything they've done on this trip around the country.
Well, that's great.
Well, and it's amazing. It's not just a series of Flickr photos. It's not just it's like a space for all that stuff.
Yeah.
It's remarkable.
And it's, when you look at the stuff, it's not like the stuff you would, it's not your best stuff. It's really kind of almost throwaway, you know. And I try a lot of shots where I like do sneaky pictures in public, and I've recorded a couple people.
Stranger shots,
and stuff that just is that kind of moment in time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But you know, I don't mind getting good photos, but it's really kind of almost really ephemeral stuff.
Yeah. That's what runs
stories.
The story box.
Yeah.
Well, thanks, Alan. We really appreciate you being here. And
Bob,
there's plenty more.
Yeah, he'll
that
be
I'm
here
sure
all
you're
week.
Be contributing.
I'm here for a week
as we go through.
I might
Friday,
never leave
Saturday,
the cuddle couch.
Sunday, Monday.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
And you should all submit your own story right now if you're watching.
Yeah.
That might be something to start. And what's the URL for them to submit it again?
Cogdogblog.com/storybox.
Yeah.
All lowercase.
And now I gotta slap myself on the wrist because I haven't submitted anything, and I'm sure Andy hasn't.
No,
so.
Andy hasn't.
No, you're right. I need to jump on that too. I'm a slacker.
Lots, I could call a long list of slackers.
Yeah. We'll do a slacker cast sometime.
No, I
so, hey, do you think
that.
Timmy Boy was mad at me today? I'm bossing him around about getting the setup.
He seemed pretty used to it.
I think I'm starting to piss him off now.
I don't know. He's pretty amazing. I mean, he kind of rummaged his stuff together in 10 minutes.
Yeah, he did.
Running it wirecast off of my laptop and getting the third setup. So.
I think I gotta be
Timmy,
nice.
Timmy boy is he's ruling the house here.
Yeah, he really is. He's starting
to
scare
so
me.
So don't
a
piss
bit.
Him off. I mean, he's got the center command console over there. He's
yeah.
kind of the helm of the Enterprise.
Well, we should do an official sign off here from DTLT today. Thanks for joining us.
Peace.
Join us again tomorrow.
Love. Thank you.